you're most likely thinking that something like this would be extremely complicated to model in Revit. Well, I'm here to tell you that it's actually quite simple and straightforward. We're going to do it in only a few minutes. Let's go. Now quickly, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. If you're serious about mastering Revit, that's definitely the best place to be, with over 140 hours dedicated to all of the interesting and complex topics inside of Revit. Now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit, and this is going to be our starting point. As you can see, I have just kind of drafted out the front facade of this house. And then we also have this line, which basically illustrates the point where the bottom terrain starts to tilt up, and then also the roof terrain kind of starts to tilt down. So this is a really important kind of mark. And then in the site plan, it's going to look like this. So basically just simple model lines. Okay, so let's get started. I'm going to go to the site plan first, and then I'm going to go to massing and site and choose the Toposolid tool. Now for the draw tools, let's pick out the rectangle, and then I'm just going to create a rectangle that's a little bit larger than this sketch. Something like this should be fine. And then for the properties, I'm just going to leave it as is. Then I'm going to go to modify, and then click on finish edit mode. So we have one of these. So we have the bottom site. Now I'm going to model the top site, and then we're going to join them together. You'll see that in a few moments. So let's go here to massing and site, go to Toposolid yet again, but now let's pick out the pick lines tool. I'm just going to select that and then hover over one of these lines, hit the tab key once, and then click to select. And now I'm going to highlight all of them, select them, and hit finish. Now these two are overlapping, and that's perfectly fine. We still have the top one, or the small one selected. So I'm going to go here to modify sub elements. It's going to basically break this down to sub elements. And then I'm going to make one big cross selection, go up here to modify sub elements and find the elevation parameter and change that to 5 meters, just like that. And then let's go to modify, go to the 3D view, and see what we have. So basically here we have the top terrain and we have the bottom terrain. Now, of course, we want them to have some curvature, and we also want them to meet in the middle back here. That's why I have three levels. So we have L1 at the bottom, L2 at the top, and mid-level where I want them to meet. So that's 2.5 meters. So I'm going to achieve this by going back to the site plan. And then here in the site plan, let's select the bottom one first, go to modify sub elements, and then let's pick add a split line. So for this split line, I'm going to set the elevation first to 0, and then I'm going to add one split line over here, just like that, going from side to side, following this reference plane that they have placed. Then for the second one, I'm going to set this to 2.5 meters, hit enter, and then I'm going to place that one over here, just like that, from one side to the other. Hit the escape key a couple of times, just like that, go to the 3D view, and now this is what we have. Now, we also want it to continue kind of horizontally here, so let's select this, go to modify sub elements again, select this line, and then let's just bring it up to 2.5 meters, just like that. Okay, now let's go back to modify to escape out of that. And now let's do the same, just in reverse for this one. So for this one, I'm going to go to modify sub elements, then I'm going to go to the site plan. And then here, this is all at 5 meters. So let's go add split line, have it at 5 meters. Also make sure that here absolute is selected. You don't want the along surface option. You want to make sure that it's set to absolute. Okay, so now let's make one over here, just like that. So basically we're locking everything in. And then for this one, I'm going to place it at around 4 meters. And then we can see, let's actually place it a bit up here, something like that. And make sure to go all the way to the other side and then click. Perfect. Hit the escape key a couple of times, and now we can go to the 3D view, and then this is what we have. So we have it kind of tilting down a little bit. Now, obviously, we want it to tilt in the back, so let's go to modify sub elements. I'm going to select this one and just change this to 2.5, just like that. Okay, so here, actually I want to bring this up a little bit. So let's go to 4.23. Okay, so we have a little bit of curvature. We can go 4.5 perhaps. There we go. So basically, more of these that you add, these split lines, the more kind of finer curvature you can have. Like this, it's a bit straight, but yeah, I mean, it still works, but if you want it to look a bit nicer, you can do that. Or you can add more of these split lines. Okay, so now once we have the main shape, let's go to Modify, go to Join Geometry, and then I'm just going to join these two just like that. Okay, so once we have all of this joined, now let's actually turn it into some building elements, and we first need walls. So for walls, what I'm going to do is go to the site plan, go to architecture, go to the wall tool. Let's pick out the generic 300 millimeter wall. Make sure that the location line is set to finish face interior. Make sure that the height is set to level 2, and then I'm just going to give it a top offset of 0.2 meters just to go a little bit above the ground. Okay, so now let's go with pick lines. I'm going to hover over one of these, see how it kind of points out to the outside. That's perfect. Now hit the tab key a few times until it highlights the entire shape, and this is what we want. So now I'm going to click and we have walls everywhere. Hit the escape key a couple of times, go to the 3D view. Obviously here we don't need the back wall, and also these walls should be following the Toposolid. So for that, let's select them, go to edit profile, use the pick lines, and then I'm just going to use an offset of 0.2 meters and then give it an offset like so. Hit the escape key a couple of times and then use trim and extend to corner to fix it up here. Hit the escape a couple of times again, delete this one and hit finish. Perfect. And now it's starting to look even better. And also we're going to be repeating the same thing on the other side. Now, once we have all of this completed, we can go to modify and then use cut geometry to cut the topography with the wall, so you can have kind of a cleaner line, and then we can do the same thing here. So cut topography with a wall. Yeah, looks much nicer. Now, I know what you may be thinking. This is all nice and it looks good, but what about inside? If I go to the site plan and then pop a section through this thing, if I open that up, it's basically earth inside. So we need to actually make some livable space inside of this mountain. And we can actually do that. So I can go here to the site plan, and then I'm going to go to architecture, go to component, model in place. I'm going to scroll all the way down and find my topo solids and click OK. Click OK again. And now I'm just going to use a void form. So let's pick out a void extrusion and then use pick lines to hover over the inside line of this wall. Hit the tab key as many times as you need until you get this. Click to select. And then I'm just going to move this inside a little bit like that. So this should give us ample living space inside of this hill. And then I can hit finish, go to section one. And now I'm just going to bring this up. So yeah, let's make it 3.8 meters. That will give us enough space to add another floor there, add walls and all of that. So we will still have high ceilings inside. Now I can just go to cut geometry and then cut this topo solid with this. Also cut this topo solid with this, and there we go. So now if I hit finish model, this is what we have. So we have this empty space inside. If I go to the 3D view and now do my favorite Revit trick, which is to turn on the section box, I can now cut this open, and now as you can see, we have some living space inside, and this is actually functioning as an actual house inside of a hill. So there we go. Something that looks extremely complicated can be achieved in Revit rather quickly and easily. Now, if you would like to get access to this Revit project file, as well as all of my other Revit project files, you can find that on my Patreon page, which I'm just going to link up in the cards above, and then also down in the description of this video. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe, for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.